Dear investor, in this video, we will discuss the quarter one result season and the government monetization plan. This is the first time we are seeing this kind of an initiative. Second, we will also note the fact that the market has attained the targets we had set for itself. And we do expect it to consolidate in a range going forward, and our reasons for the same. Lastly, would share our belief on spaces which may do well, and why do we believe that the leaders in high quality space could do relatively better going forward. On the first subject, quarter one results and the government plan. A few notings. One, the quarter one result season was good. There were more companies which met expectation, lesser disappointed, and overall the aggregates were in line with expectations. Basis this, the outlook for financial 22 and financial 23 has remained unchanged. The point to note is that metals drove the earnings in quarter one and could do that again in quarter two, and hence for financial 22. So of the three large pools, where we see large delta in terms of profit in financial 22, it would be metals, IT and financials. While we say this, it is important to understand that in financial 23, metals are expected to, grow profits a bit, because the metal prices themselves, we believe, are at unsustainably high levels. And the drop in metal profits would have to be made up by other spaces. We would have to watch for the solidness of FY23 numbers as we progress. On the policy front, over the last period, government shared a list of assets that it wanted to monetize, and that could top $6 trillion. Now, 6 trillion rupees. Now, this is a large, large number. We really believe it is good. It will help recycle capital, take it out of assets which are already built, and maybe use it to build newer assets, and thereby kickstarting the CapEx cycle in the country. This would be a good welcome step. However, at the same time, we would like to point out that the corporate-focused banks who were earlier lenders to such projects would now have to find newer avenues to lend. And it is now evident that the assets generating predictable earning stream are being sold off, and such banks would increasingly have to lend for riskier assets, riskier cash flow streams. This has been our thesis for long, and one of our reasons why we focus on non-standard smaller ticket lending. Coming down to the second topic, market has attained our annual target, and we do expect some period of consolidation. The past period was good in terms of market buoyancy, over 6% as we speak, and the Nifty crossed our target of 16,500. And has sustained there. Why do we expect consolidation? Point one, valuations are fuller. Just to recount, what we have been saying is that from the December 19 peak of the index till now, we are up like 33% on the index. And the earnings increase of 15%, of FY21 over 20, and a discount rate change of 1%, which increases the value of businesses to our mind between 15 and 20% account for most of the valuation increase that we have seen in this period, and does leave some amount of upside. Moreover, from March 21, the year last fiscal end, we have moved further into the new year. Five months are behind us. If we expect FY23 to do 15+% growth over FY22, it would mean 6-7% kind of a further move up if markets have to stay in line with earnings growth. So that does leave some amount of upside. However, at the same time, as we speak, the market is getting focused on taper, and we will talk of that going forward. Taper both in India, where monetary policy could normalize, and in the West. As we enter the busy season, we would see the excess liquidity in the system get normalized, and that can result in some amount of uptick in interest rates. We have noted that 0.25% increase in interest rates does cause 5% damage to the valuations, which in some sense would take like or absorb 4 months of earnings upside on the index. Basis these, we had spoken of 16,500 target on the Nifty with some upward bias, and that's happened. If in case the monetary policy stays accommodative in India and globally for longer, or if in India the COVID 3 wave is benign, we could see a sharper upside. Otherwise, we do expect, like I said, markets to consolidate in a range. The second point is, where is the money going? One, money is going into IPOs, and the torrent of IPOs continues. And two, there is some sense that money is getting stuck in IPOs. Some of the recent ones have not done as well. They've listed at a discount, and that does hamper the recycling of monies, and may just cause that damage to the sentiment. That said, the torrent of IPOs continues. FY22 is expected to be the largest year in terms of IPOs, with several of the largest ever IPOs hitting. The markets, we have seen Zomato, we expect to see a Paytm going forward, and LIC again, there is news that the government wants to end before fiscal 22. Now, IPOs would absorb substantial new money inflow into the market, and that may again cause markets to consolidate for some time. In the past, in periods of high IPO activity, we have always seen that. Third, we should not discount the possibility of the third COVID wave. Typically, in India, the third COVID wave, has followed the Western COVID waves by 2 odd months. West is having its third wave just now, which kind of, in terms of timeline, puts an October kind of a period for us to expect the onset of third wave in the country. If because of inoculations, which have moved on an healthy manner in India and is covering sizable part of the country, or on account of antibodies, people in India have been exposed and have developed COVID antibodies. if we experience a more gentler third wave, it would be a big positive, but we should be prepared and time only will tell. The other thing that's happened is that margining rules have been changed. Regulator has been doing it slowly, gradually over a period of time to make the markets more safer. And now for being in the marketplace, participants would have to put in 100% of margins from 1st of September. And, the fear is that it may impact volumes for some time before normalizing again. It's not a directional negative, but more a sentimental negative, which could cause markets to consolidate for some time. Lastly, on the global side, we are seeing some signs of growth peaking out. Now, maybe this is on account of the third wave, which has been bad in that part of the world. But the point to note is, as that part of the world comes out of its third wave, we would be hitting the taper of monetary, of fiscal, this thing, kind of coinciding with the time people come out of the third wave. And that may just prove to be a bit of a challenge for the rebound that we have seen from COVID lows, unless, of course, timelines are revisited. Now, jury is out as to whether what is the main cause of peaking out of global growth rate. And yes, it could be a breather and the growth may start again. Or it could be on account of COVID, and as COVID recedes, it could again pick up. So those are the things that we would look out for. And yes, in this period, US has seen bad third wave, and China has seen a series of lockdowns on smallest of numbers. And these are the two largest economies in the world. That has definitely been one of the causes of a slowdown. If it reverses, good. Else, if the growth has to continue, it may require more support from the FESC. And like I said before, it may mean that the tapering, which is expected from December, January, kind of a period, may have to be pushed back. Or otherwise, if economic growth has to sustain, people may have to dip into their savings, and the savings are looking healthier than usual. And that, again, we believe has a high chance of success, because the job market is buoyant, and that should make people confident to spend. So we stay hopeful, while we do note that the strong recovery is taking a breather. Now, going forward, both in India and the West, like I said, we do expect policy normalization to start to occur. In the busy season, liquidity surpluses in India may automatically become lower. Bank credit may pick up, and that should cause the surpluses with RBI to reduce. This in itself can increase the bond yields, and a 25%, 25 bips increase in bond yields could impact valuations by around 5%, as we have noted before. And it would take 4 months of earning expansion to neutralize this, once again causing some consolidation. An added point is the strength in the commodity space. People have observed the strength and seen it as a validation of a very strong economic recovery. However, to our mind, while that may be partly true, maybe supply disruptions are a bigger part of the story. What may also be happening is that because of the positive price feedback, the producers may be overproducing. In commodities like steel, it is already evident. We do expect that in the second half, steel production levels may need to be cut on a global basis if steel prices have to sustain, else we should expect them to have a step back. And similar could be the case for other commodities. Now, one comment on portfolios, how we look at the market. A drop in commodity prices would be good for users of commodity. Our portfolios primarily focuses on users of commodities and not on commodity producers, in the manufacturing space, and hence we do believe our portfolios could see some tailwinds. We would watch this space for more signals going forward. Lastly, coming down to where we see opportunities, we do believe the high quality businesses in leadership positions in their spaces could do relatively better. That's been our focus. A consolidation in the market in the present period should thus prove to be a good opportunity to build portfolios for the longer term. Leaders in various emerging spaces could do well. We have spoken of this before. The CMI study of top 3,000 companies does show that the top 900 companies are doing relatively better. Policy environment has been changing for the better, with better access to domestic market on import duty protections and encouragements in the form of PLI scheme rollouts, which is benefiting industry after industry. Most of the players who are benefiting are in the sub 40,000 crore market cap range. In terms of our investing, we are focused on the electronic space, as this is the space which is seeing the largest quantum of benefit under the PLI, divided under two or three heads. Point is that one company can bid under all of these heads. China Plus One is benefiting pharmaceuticals, chemicals, and API industries. Even in these spaces, there is some PLI benefit, but the overriding factor is China Plus One sourcing strategy, and that's the other thing which is reflecting in the portfolios. Demand for IT services is strong. Mid caps in this space are doing actually better than larger peers. Valuation support is also here to some extent. If we track the performance of mid cap space in the large cap space from financial 07 till date, we get this feedback that this is a space which has already done well, and the valuations are no longer supportive. So what we did was to go back a long way, started from 2007. When we do that, we see mid-cap still trailing behind, hence have some valuation tailwinds definitely left for them. We have noted that in period of strong economic growth, mid-caps do relatively better. And the current period where the economy is reflating after a COVID setback is one such period. When I look at the earnings momentum of our universe, our universe is a universe of around 200 high quality businesses, where we do believe a potential of high quality and high growth exists. Now, over the next 2 years, I see that the earning compounding of the space below 40,000 crores of market cap is materially higher than that of the larger companies. Now, actually, in the higher quality space, this has been the case in most of the years over the past period, barring one, clearly showing that higher quality space leaders are performing relatively better. Even if they are in the the mid cap space, in the less than 40,000 crore market cap space. We do believe that stock market performance follows earning performance, and hence the leaders of these new emerging spaces should do well going forward. To sum up, while there is upside in the market going forward, we do expect secondary market to consolidate, and we noted the reasons. Mid-caps have taken a step back, and we do believe offers more upside versus large caps, particularly the high quality businesses who are space leaders. And we do believe this period of consolidation could be a good time to build portfolios for the long term. We also believe that the easy money is behind us, okay? And investors would do well to take the services of a manager focused on quality businesses like ourselves. In terms of sectors, we have noted before, between key large profit growing spaces, metals, IT and financials, we are focused more on IT and financials. We do believe metals could peak out. We have been saying this for the last two or three videos, and our focus on IT and financial is on account of better sustainability and predictability of numbers here, as well as better valuation comfort. Among smaller companies, chemicals, APIs continue to hold promise for us. We are bringing out a new portfolio to take advantage of these emerging themes. And as we speak, Emerging Opportunities Fund is there in the market, just been launched. This is a fund where for the first time, we have a completely digital mode of onboarding. To improve the experience of clients in such COVID impacted periods. Hope you guys use the opportunity. Thank you, everybody. Happy investing.